Operational report. Submarines detected. Moho! Occupied! Nice. This is the dot base in Manchuria. Repairs complete. Contact report. Contract. Oh, and another midget submarine, supposedly under attack. Contact report. Contact report. Recon Shimonoseki. Recon Kochi. Recon Langkawi and Tanyong Pinang. Kill credit. Recon. Oh, yes, we're taking a look at Kochi. Going to make sure that it's still empty. Kill credit. Contact report. Here's the another midget submarine supposedly hit by a Catalina. Contact report. Contact report. Repair is complete. Oh, lots of ships done. Replacements taken. Refit begins. Upgrades. Repairs complete. Reinforcements, Alameda. Lots of reinforcements. Okay, we have Alameda, Eastern U.S., Pearl Amphibious Force, Pearl Harbor, Eastern U.S., Tacoma. Wow, lots and lots. More construction regiments. An air wing at Aden. 16th Army. This is an Army headquarters. And the Soviets get reinforcements. Let's take a look quickly at the one at Pearl Harbor. Here's the Amphibious Force. Ah, this is an interesting case. The Amphibious Force, this is a special amphibious landing force. By have an amphibious landing headquarters helps the landing units disembark more efficiently. If this is aimed at, let's say, well, hell, let's aim it at Cochin. If this was aimed at Cochin and it had 100 points, or let's say 100 points, it was command radius 1, and it was in a ship. There's a special ship called a command ship, AGC vessel. If there was a command ship vessel and this was sitting one hex range of the invasion beach, then the invasion forces get a bonus for disembarkation. They disembark with less disruption. Which would have been nice to know. However, I can't sit around waiting 100 days for this to get the accumulate the planning points required for Kochi. I could try another landing somewhere else, but if I can get on in Kochi, well, Kochi's going now, so there's really no point in planning for Kochi. That will never happen. Where would I? I don't even know where I would conduct another landing. Oita? We'll leave it for Oita, simply because I have no other option for another landing. Interesting to note that the headquarters arrives, but the command ship AGC does not. I think it's significant to note that the command ship AGC, or class of ships that carry the amphibious headquarters, they did not arrive, but I could still load it up into any regular amphibious ship or any cargo ship, and I would still get the benefit as long as the headquarters is present. I don't believe it's the command ship that improves the disembarkation. It's the headquarters. Looking over at Hong Kong, we have no submarines ready to go at Hong Kong, but we have several ready to go Grampus is due for a refit. Kingfish will be repairing as well. So Grampus will throw in on... It's going to refit anyway. And Kingfish needs repairs. We'll put it into critical. The other three, one for each station. Nagasaki, Shikoku, and Chiba Station. We've arrived at Suitao. So put everybody into combat mode. I could bring aircraft over right away, but the AI hasn't bothered with Suitao. I don't want to encourage him to bomb Suitao. If we want to bring them over, where are those guys? The Hurricanes are here. We could pop over in a jiffy. And instead, I think I'm going to base them out of Hong Kong, ready to intervene on a moment's notice. I'm keeping them at Hong Kong just in case when these guys disappear on the 31st, I don't know, they disappear and return on the same day, I think. If they disappear and return on the same day, that's great. If they disappear and return somewhere else, I will need the Hurricanes to fly night combat air patrol to cover their gap, their absence. On Fusan, the priority for recon is we're going to try to make sure that Kochi base is open. So we're conducting recon over Kochi and Karume. Kochi, we only have a 6 out of 7, but we're pretty certain it's still empty. One of these things, I know, in against a human, he would notice that there's lots of recon over an empty beach and probably get the hint that this is probably open to invasion. But it's the AI. The AI is unable to make that intuitive leap. We're going to conduct reconnaissance over Karume. We're going to attack Karume. The fortresses, I've ordered them to stand down. Oh, we've got one on Karume, and why do we have two on Karume? Kochi, I don't need to fly two recon missions over Karume. Let's see, Shimonoseki we just hit. Fukuoka, we notice it's still burning. We've got 20 light industry damage and resources damage here. So if he's got supplies here, we're burning up 10,000 a month, or 2,000 a day, if that's the case. So we won't bomb Fukuoka just yet. Kirume does not seem to have any fires. We don't notice anything still burning, so maybe it's all repaired. Kumamoto, it says there are fires, but I don't see any damage on it. So I'm going to conduct reconnaissance on Kumamoto as a potential bomb target. But we're going to keep looking at Kochi, keep it under surveillance, just in case something appears. The fortresses are standing down, recovering. The Mitchells are also standing down. They took a loss. I think they lost a plane. No, they're recovering. The fatigue is at 4 and 6, so we're going to stand them down. I've decided to... I know it's taxing. Look, we're overstacking the aircraft. But I'm going to fly the Warhawks. They did so well on strafing those barges. Those, not barges, but subchasers they were. I'm going to do it again. I'm putting them on patrol at range of 2. Unfortunately, there's no search function for these guys, so they can't go out and actually conduct patrol. If someone else detects the ships, these guys will attack them, hopefully. But otherwise, they don't do anything themselves. So, yeah, the fatigue is there, but I don't think the fatigue will build up if they don't actually fly. So they're going to fly up to the range of the strait, just in case there are any other subchasers that want to patrol the area. They will hopefully go out and destroy them. Keijo, the Delta Ones completed their mission and are now recovering from the experience, resting. The good thing is we didn't lose anybody. That's the most important part. Nobody died. So for that, I shall be grateful. The 24 B-24s are going out tonight. I'm sending the 5th Command. I'm going to send 5th Bomber Command. No, 7th Bomber Command. I thought about sending them along. I did order them originally. but they've got a little bit of fatigue left over, so I'm going to rest these guys. 7th Bomber Command can sit it out tonight. The rest are going after Karume. So I will rest the entire... This gives me a little bit of flexibility. So tonight, if 5th Bomber Command delivers the goods, tomorrow night, 7th Bomber Command can chase a different target. We're almost finished rebuilding up on Fusan. Oh, 92. If it only went up from 85.7% up to 92. So we've been averaging 8 and 9%, I think about 8%. If with a little bit of luck, we'll get an 8% boost this turn, and we will be over the top next turn. Still, not really any units coming in. There's a couple of headquarters coming through, more headquarters coming up to reinforce. I brought all my transports into Keijo. Right now, we've overstacked the base a little bit, but I'm bringing down the base force from Changchun. Hopefully, that will bring them back up to the aviation requirements. But we're just stacking, we're just waiting, gathering forces for the attack. Over on the Taiwan pocket, another wing coming through. Taiwan pocket, we are now over 4,100, so we are going to recombine and go into the attack. This time, when we went on the attack, I managed to remember not to include the army group, so we didn't cancel their progress out of the hex. Nice, the filter actually works. We turned off the HQ, set everyone to deliberate, and turned them back, and then added them back on, so I didn't wipe out their progress. Just sloppy play on my part. Okay, we have more headquarters, air headquarters coming through, as well as base forces, and base forces just getting on the, just arriving in Wuchang, where they're already on the rail. So I ordered them right down to Fusan instead of stopping at Hangzhou. Just go straight on through. Do not pass go. Do not pick up Chow Mein. Over on, we're still marching up, more base forces up the Nanning Road. I don't know what to call that, Nanning Road. The Chindits are just out Hue and Touraine. Looks like they're going to, damn it, looks like they're going to miss the party. Ah, crap. Okay, probably what happened here was, let me see. Did they get off the road? Did they get off the railroad? Let me see. They're moving at 38. It says road movement, and that may explain why they're moving so slowly. See, this is rail movement. And maybe if I can order them up to Hangzhou, it goes on road movement. So this is, Hangzhou is... Eventually, it has to go by road movement, so I think I'm going to go here to Langson. We'll order it on railroad to Langson. At least it gets here more quickly than by going two separate steps. I suspect because Hangzhou, you have to cross a bunch of roads, it stays on the road all the way through, so that's less efficient. These guys, these guys are also going on the road, so I think I'll order them to Langson. At least we get the fast part of it here, and then the slow part of it later. No other reinforcements coming down through Bangkok. The Kowloon Brigade is trying to get out of here. Hold on, what the hell? Maybe do the same thing. Let's try to use the railroad as best we can. So it doesn't mix, unfortunately. Okay, so we'll just have to do it manually. Railroad. Singapore. Oh, there's still some enemy midget submarines here. The S-40, we're heading off to Hong Kong. Looking at the Mitchells, where I'm a little concerned, I don't know if flying at low altitude increases fatigue. I don't know. It might. We'll keep an eye on it. At the 11 level, it's still acceptable. I don't want to be losing planes and pilots for nothing, for a useless mission. So we'll keep an eye on that. Loading up. Oh, Alor Star. Getting more trainee pilots in here. Pulling out the experienced, putting more trainees in. Yeah, I'll take more losses, but how it's the only way to train them. Bangkok, nobody coming through. Yeah, Kowloon coming through. We're unloading again the partials at Rangoon. Mulmian, we have one base force dropped in. Get them off the rail, off the train, down to Bangkok. At Xuebo, we have no additional reinforcements, no additional reinforcements in Pal. The Chinese army has arrived at the road junction here. Let's see, what happens if I order him to march directly to the hex? Does he go down? He goes east and then across. That's all we can hope for. Yep, that's all for which we can hope. So we are marching. It'll follow the road up and then hopefully over top rather than going. Yeah, I'm sure it'll go. Chittagong is sucked dry. 10 points. I don't even see how the bombers are flying with that level of supply. Or maybe it's the bombers eating up all that supply. I don't think so. I doubt it. I doubt it. Quiet over on Ceylon. Convoy has arrived in Bombay. Unloading. Here comes another one. We may have to let these guys. Oh yeah, there's 62,000 unloading. The escorts will probably leave them here, go back out, get another convoy, and then switch off. Convoy unloading at Karachi and one loading at Abadan. No additional reinforcements, Aden. My mistake. We did get a reinforcement over at Aden, a wing reinforcement. We'll turn on the replacements. Aim this sucker for Kobe. Plan for Kobe. The last two transports I sent out of here accidentally somehow ended up in Abadan. Oh well. We've got plenty of other transports to load to use. We'll load them when. Yeah, in 2 days. Looks like no reinforcements in South Africa. This ship is still in refit. Torpedo submarine check. No damaged submarines to return. Checking the endurance. Drum is already returning. Ho needs to come back. Thank you for the button. Ho and Poji. Well, where are you, Poji? Ah, there you go. Huge list. Sailfish should also return. Any others? We already brought back swordfish. Okay. Torpedo check. No submarine engagements that turn, unfortunately. Quiet over in Timor. I moved some P-38 Echoes over here to make the great leap forward. They've rested, they've recovered. Now let's strap on the tanks. Let's go for it. How far can we transfer? Whoo! Oh boy, we can get up to Kota Baru. Why not? Off we go. Turn them off. Let them recover. The other ground forces have arrived at Alice Springs. They're getting on the train, moving south. I'm putting a couple of engineers into Old Nadata. We'll just build it up to a quick level one base before we head south. It's just that these guys, the Cavite, will head down because it's already been purchased. The other ones, the Australia commands, we're going to drop them into Old Nadata just because we can. We don't need them right away. These guys are being built. Yeah, we these guys are purchased. I just don't have enough points to buy out the Australia command yet. These other ones, these are the troops that we evacuated from the cadre that have rebuilt, we evacuated from Hong Kong. Now that they're back on a rail line, I'm going to turn on their upgrades, let them upgrade. Now that we have lots of supply coming up from Sydney, we have more coming down. Yeah, more of these guys. You know, if with these guys that are Australia restricted, I'll save them for building the base. These guys that are unrestricted, I'm going to send them down to Sydney, just in case we can load them up and get them out. I don't think we're going to have many ships coming through, as we're starting the invasion of Japan already. So I'll leave the restricted units to build up these little base. Wow. Yeah. We've got a couple of other ones. We're moving up on Bork. We'll build that in a few days. We've got Condamine. We're up to 56% already. It's just building like a son of a gun. Yeah, we have 108 engineers. So we'll pop that one up. We'll pop up Coffs Harbor. We'll pop up. Just nothing to do. Boring as snot back here. As we wait for ships to... Suffolk is completed. We are waiting for the transport, the landing ship, and the destroyer to complete. New Zealand, still unloading at Christchurch. Yeah, slowly, slowly. Slowly, slowly. As are these guys. These guys are actually doing it much more quickly because it's a bigger dock. I don't think there's any naval support here either. Nope, no naval support. Guadalcanal, these... Oops, I better not unload the Wren detachment. When we get there. Guadalcanal, since we can't suck out 4,000 points per turn, now they're sucking out 200 points or so per turn. I don't know how long this will last. Nothing happening, Panama. We have another ship up here. Okay, these are the transports. Arrive, heading for Pearl. At Pearl Harbor, we have the AO still trying to unload so that she can upgrade. And another tender unloading so that she can return to San Francisco. Otherwise, nothing's happening in Pearl Harbor. More transports coming in. Got another special forces group going, special transport group heading for Auckland. Makes me wonder if I should even how many more of these I need to send, since the units down there are all pretty much purchased. We don't have much, we can't buy any more of them. Okay, transports, tenders moving across to Ini Witok, tender, empty tanker returning to San Francisco. Lots of reinforcements on the west coast. We have Alameda, ships have arrived. Okay, send them over to San Francisco. Over in Portland. Where are they? Oh, okay, Port Wayneem. We have engineers arrived here. It's kind of odd to see these engineers, these combat engineers. They're already purchased. They're ready to go. They're ready to move out, so I'm going to buy them out and, move them over to San Francisco for transshipment. It's really kind of odd to see, here are all these other base forces building their base, and these guys are leaving. Why? Because they can actually get off the damn continent! We'll turn on the... replacements and reef and upgrades over at Marchfield. We have more engineers arrive. Okay, we'll turn on, we'll also set them for San Francisco because they can. Los Angeles, I believe an engineer, not Los Angeles. Where else? We have San Francisco, okay. March, San Diego, that's where it was. San Diego and Tacoma. San Diego has a base force. It's North Pacific, great. It's assigned, it's clear. Off you go, San Francisco, Tacoma has another base force, great, set, turn them all on. Did Portland never got one. Eastern USA, we have two base forces, or one base force. Turned it on. Get them on the train. Down to San Francisco. What else is here? We have aircraft. These are trainers, okay. Get them in training mode. Oh, yeah, we've already got the 13 here, so that's it. Let's see. Check on the pilots. Pretty decent pilots. Whoa. These guys know what they're doing. So get them out of here. Promote them. Grab guys who do not know what they're doing. Transports. Let's grab the dummies from the bottom. The tedium. How many times have I had to click on this? 4 times to bring up the same table to do the same, to do one thing I wanted to do? God almighty. All right. Transfer them down to San Francisco. Were there anybody else? Did I miss anybody? Can't even remember. And there is San Francisco. And we know about Pearl Harbor already. Okay. San Francisco. We have one aviation base force. Where are you? Here you go. Pack up. We are also, we can set them for anything. I'm just going to set them for Kochi. Kochi hopefully will be in our hands by the time these guys get out there. They better be in our hands. We're going to be in real trouble if they aren't. Lots of ships have dropped into repair and refit. We still have these idiots trying to unload their 500 points so that they can refit. Bloody hell. For that reason, we got to make sure that they actually dock, or else they may not unload it quickly enough. So we got to take the tankers out. These are the long-range tankers. Most of them are filled, but there's still a few points. If we're going to go all that way down there, I want to fill up a few hundred, whatever, these 7,000, 6,000 more. 3,000 more. We'll send them once these 3,000 are done. And these guys are filling. Okay, nobody is ready to go yet. We're waiting for the aviation brigade, aviation base force. So meanwhile, if there's any spares, we will just load regular supplies. Nothing here is ready to go. No, we don't have the points to purchase these. San Francisco, we have jammed the docks with tankers and these stupid transports trying to unload their little 500 points of fuel. Jammed up the whole dock for the whole day. So nothing's loading. We'll take this opportunity to repair just a crap load of ships. We've got 120 ships all trying to repair or refit in the pier. So this turn is a non-loading turn. But just imagine all the repairs that are being done here at these large shipyards compared to what's happening over. This would never happen, never be possible in Vancouver with its smaller shipyard. But these are mostly loaded. The ones that are loaded, okay, the troop transports making their, they'll finish off, then make their run for Pearl Harbor, while the others head for Guam. On the islands, the first elements of the 1st Cavalry Division are arriving. Okay, we're getting them to unload. I realize that with all the ships heading up to the invasion beaches, we got a gap here. We don't have anything going back. And that means I'm storing all the ships here and nothing. Well, we can't exactly send any more cargo ships up here without escort. And all the escorts are heading north. So instead of just storing them and sitting there on Guam, I've ordered them all back. Even my little puddle jumpers, my little guys, the 2900s, they're with 6,000 endurance, they have enough range to get back. So I'm sending them back. Normally I would use them to evacuate Australia, but they're doing nothing. They can't go to Australia either. Well, they could go, but I don't want to risk running afoul of any aircraft out of truck without air support. So I am sending them all these guys back, just lots and lots of them back in small penny packets, so to try to avoid the collision. Knock wood. We haven't had one in a long time. I don't want to give them one now. So we're sending all these little 3900s, 3200s back to carry what they can up to the front. The AOs have proven very useful. Too bad that we're stuck with the fast ones here. We're loading them, and the base is unable to keep up with the fuel needs. So it's a lucky thing that I did have some AOs around here to help refuel some of the ships. But now that they're coming in smaller amounts, little small groups of ships, Guam should be able to handle it. It's just that when all these hundreds of ships return from the invasion beaches, that's when we're going to need a lot more. We've got tankers inbound on Iwo Jima. With luck, we won't be bombed or torpedoed as they make their approach. It would be a real hassle if I had to assemble in Pagan, then move up to Iwo every single time. At Iwo, we have, a lot of these transport ships have arrived. Support ships are here, ready to go. The slowest moving one is not the battleships here, not these. These are the escorts. It looks like this hex has three of the slower moving ones. So we're going to redirect these guys, order them towards Shikoku right away. And I'm going to order these guys back out of Iwo Jima to follow. They're backtracking, they're losing time, they're losing fuel, absolutely. But this is the only way I could make sure these are the slowest ones, and I'll use these, I'll make this one of these the lead ships heading for Shikoku. The escorts are only one day behind them, so that's not bad. That's not bad. They should be able to catch up at a slightly higher rate of travel. Here are the battleships. The battleships, again, two hexes behind. I think they should be able to catch up just fine. The submarines are in the lead. These are my troop transport submarines. They should be able to get to the beaches beforehand and land the troops one day ahead. Chichijima, checking weather. Well, Chichijima is covered by cloud. I'll take note again that we were not attacked at night by by bombers. So either the 18 full, that's what we need on combat air patrol. We also were not attacked on Hahajima, so the bow fighters on night, the night bow fighters could also be relevant. I don't know which yet. So I'm hoping to leapfrog some of these Corsairs into Japan once we capture the bases, because this is the closest approach. I'll leave them on combat air patrol for now. Okay, we're going to take these guys. We're going to break them down. And I'm going to slowly cancel the night patrols. See if I can't bring it down to zero. And hope that the AI will not be bombing us. So we'll slowly reduce it and see if the bow fighter night fighters can keep the enemy away. We're on patrol. We're a fatigue level of only 4, so I'm going to keep increasing this until we get to hopefully 10, lower than 10. If I can fly all of them at every mission, that would be great. That would be great. Right, the fleet carriers have arrived at Iwo Jima along with most of the destroyers and all the other fast ships. We've got AK the support ships 1, support ship 2, all here. They came a little bit ahead of these transports. So we're going to have to backtrack to meet them and then come up again. So, yeah, we're going to run a couple extra hexes, burn a little bit more fuel than required. But it does go to show that we set them off and we managed to catch up to them at the boat at about the right place. My only regret is that my obsession with fueling the tankers, I brought all the oilers back. I wish I had left an oiler up here with some fuel so we could top off the destroyers before they left. The destroyers are always thirsty, damn it. So my failure. The down here we at least have the, where are these guys, the oilers are here, transport. We're setting them up so at least they can get a drink, even right up near Kochi base if needed. But I'm putting them into harm's way. That could be a mistake, but I've got enough escorts. I'm hoping that we're here to stay. I'm even bringing, I often forget, but I'm even remembering to bring, where are the support? I even brought a repair vessel with me, because if something gets hit over in Kochi, it's a hell of a long way to come all the way back down here just for minor repairs. Hopefully the repair vessel will help those, even if there's some major repairs, they'll help them, it'll help it get enough mobility that it can actually run out. What I don't want is having something stuck and trying to move out of here at 5 knots. It's suicide. Plus, I'll be risking other escorts trying to bring it out to try to bring out a crippled ship. And hopefully I can change the cripple into a mobile ship with a repair vessel. So I'm risking the repair vessel here. I have another repair vessel coming in, so I've got two here finishing, and they're finishing repairs. You know what? I think I'll do it right now. I'm going to put one of the support vessels. We'll put the fast moving. We'll put the Jason, right? We'll send Jason up to Iwo Jima for those ships that are running, that are in trouble on the way back. They can stop off and get some more repairs at Iwo Jima. That may be their only. They may not be able to make it all the way back down to Guam. So I want to give them some support. If they can get out to Iwo, we can repair them. In a perfect world, once we get a few more of these floating repair docks, I'll move the floating repair dock from here, from Guam. Where is it now? I don't even see. Oh, the ARD, right. The floating repair dock. I'll move one floating repair dock up to Iwo and leave one on Guam to handle those kinds of repairs. So these guys are backtracking. Here's number 223. This is now the Kochi lead. Everybody is following her. She's going to run over Iwo Jima and then head up and down. The submarines are in the lead. We've got all these other battleships and everything. The Sovereign is trying to catch up. I don't know if he'll make it. I don't know. We are 2, 4, 5 days behind. That's a hell of a lot of time to make up. If worse comes to worse, I'll just have to leave them. I'll have to hold them at Iwo until the carriers come back and retrieve them. Not something I'd like to see. I'd like to have the battleships there, but if you don't have air cover, you don't have air cover. At Iwo, I have dropped out a couple of these destroyer escorts and destroyers. These are my Brit destroyers. They're fine for escort. They're fine for anti-submarine warfare. They just don't have the range. I don't think they have the range to get up there. They'd be more taxing. They might force the transports to slow down in order to give them fuel. I don't want this group slowing down. So I'm holding them back. I'm also bringing up some slower. Here's the Ramleys. Oh gosh, Ramleys are a real slow poker like the others. I don't think she's going to make it. Unfortunately, she's got big guns. I'd sure like to get those big guns on the battle, but needs must. Here are more Australian and English destroyers. This is Napier. Yeah, it's Australian. Warramunga is Australian, and Stuart is Australian. They're shorter ranged. I don't think they're going to. Let's take a look. Yeah, the Stuart might make it up there. Stuart might be okay. But the others are their range is too might be prohibitive. I'm still bringing them up. Here, I'm going to form. I'll take the Stuart and the Redoubt. Might actually be useful. Okay, they might make it up here. So I'm going to send them to Kochi. And what we're going to do is we're going to ram them through, use a waypoint. Everybody's using the waypoint Iwo Jima. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going this route up to here because these LSTs, they should travel, on average, they travel about 6 hexes per turn. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is probably where they will end up. I'm even bringing the slower, the battleships. Here's the Wales, Prince of Wales, trying to catch up. I'm bringing these. Frobisher is a slower cruiser, again lower range. They may not be able to help very much, but I'm bringing them over to Iwo Jima along with some extra escorts. These are destroyer escorts. The Van Heemskerk is quite short range, only 3,500 endurance, so she's a real hindrance. Great guns, but great hindrance too. Just unable to maneuver. So I'm bringing all this, even the slow stuff, these cruisers are heading up, but I'm bringing the Heemskerk and other destroyer escorts. I'm throwing them at Iwo Jima. If ships are damaged up here and they're moving out, I can use some of these shorter range ones perhaps to come out. Once they get past a certain area, we can send them in as escorts to try and retrieve them and help them get out of here. That way I don't have to risk a lot of the big ships. I got to keep the big guys moving. They're the ones that carry the big troops, and once they're in and out, I can't leave them behind for stragglers. So if there are going to be invasion or some other surface groups around here, these cruisers and light and destroyers and destroyer escorts, I'll leave here to deal with them. Yeah, you see there's a gap. There's nothing in between these. Nothing else is coming up to Iwo Jima except the repair ship. So once these guys go in, they're going all the way to Shikoku, and until they come back, I have no need for all the transport ships here. I'm sending them home. Night attack on Kurume. The liberators set the place on fire. 28 hits is good, I hope. Kurume bombed again, 22 more, 50, that's 73 hits so far on the base, 73, almost 100 hits on the base. Good for points, but will it burn enough of the other facilities? Let's hope we don't lose too many bombers on that. Kurume was almost like a milk run, an easy hit. The cavalry unloads and merges. Sargo fires a torpedo, hits a tanker, great. Air raid on Oita, fighter sweep, 3 nates destroyed. Fighter sweep, Oita, no enemy aircraft. Air attack, Alora Star, 7 aircraft in. Crap. Yeah, that's what it costs when you want to train pilots. You have to put student pilots into the aircraft. You're going to lose one. Bombing practice at Gab. Ground combat at the in the Taiwan pocket, 29-1 odds. Heavy. Oh man, look at that! 367! And he's supposed to be crippled! Crap! Oh, wow. But we destroyed 53 of his, and he's not coming back. Okay. Still, it must be that 63rd division. Yeah. Isolated, out of supply, starving for 5 months, maybe 6, and he still fights like a lion. Expansions on Iwo. Oh, great. Iwo has maximized. No. Actually, it can go to 4, so it can go one more. Okay. We can put more fighters on here. Fusan expands to 9, maximized. And Port Wainim expands as well.